We need to fix space junk before it's too late. As of 2020, there were over 19,000 pieces of individually tracked space junk in orbit above the Earth. Of those, a mere 2,200 were operational satellites. As more and more satellites go up, the risk of collisions increases. And what are governments gonna do? Basically, nothing. In addition to the 19,000 known pieces of space junk, there is an estimated 15,000 pieces larger than 10 centimeters across whipping around the Earth. An estimated 1 million pieces larger than a centimeter. And in 2007, the Chinese government conducted an anti-satellite missile test by launching a kinetic kill vehicle, essentially a rocket-fired bullet, basically, at a defunct weather satellite. That single incident generated over 3,000 tracked and monitored pieces of space junk. It was literally like a storm up there, many of which remain in orbit till today. February 10, 2009, a communication satellite managed by the Iridium company collided with an old Russian military satellite. These two satellites were obliterated, literally, leading to over 2,000 cataloged pieces of space junk as satellite-based internet companies continue to launch fleets and fleets of mega constellations into orbit. The risk of collisions is only growing with time. While the drag of our atmosphere can clean up some small pieces of space junk, we're actually dangerously close to a tipping point called the Kessler syndrome. After the NASA scientist who first outlines the possibility that space junk collisions can cascade into more collisions, which generate even more junk, which generate even more space junk, which spiraling out of control can basically completely destroy an inaccessible for a generation life. Because like, what do we do about all this space junk? What do you do? I mean, right now, not much. The US Space Surveillance Network, part of the spaceport, they monitor space junk and they issue warnings to the individual satellite operators to make decisions about maneuvers. But proposals around cleaning up space junk, all the solutions are pretty much costly and ineffective. However, in 2018, the SET Remove Debris mission practiced grabbing a satellite with a giant net. Grabbing a net, however, these methods are only useful for large satellites orbiting the Earth. There isn't really a way for us to pick up smaller pieces of debris, such as bits of paint and metal and whatever the hell lies up there. I mean, we just have to wait for them to naturally re-enter Earth's atmosphere. And the current worldwide strategy is basically to launch and cross our fingers. So yeah, it's pretty dangerous. I mean, standing up there is like, imagine having a whole hurricane, but instead of like wind particles, you have glass shreds rotating at almost like speed of sound, which is quite devastating. Check out this video right here where we talk about James Webb's breaking philosophy of physics. It's incredible what this telescope is currently doing, and it's going to change the world forever. So stay tuned. See you soon. Cheers.